好，好，感谢主，感谢主带领我们在这个主日的早晨，一同在主的桌子前来纪念、来敬拜他。
We thank our Lord on this morning of the Lord that we can come before His table to worship Him and give Him thanks.
我们真巴不得像主自己所说的，他巴不得和我们一同合心的。
And together with him, we are so hope that we may drink anew with him.
但愿我们的心能够每一次在擘饼的时候，我们都能够有一个更渴慕主回来的心思。
So that our heart hopes that every time when with him, our heart will be renewed.
让因着我们这样的心能够催促我们的主早一点的回来。
So that our heart may urge us to hope.Pray that our Lord may return sooner.
我们感谢主给我们有这几堂的聚会。
We thank our Lord for giving us this few sessions of the gathering.
虽然我们相隔两地，我在香港，大家在纽约。
Although we're all in different locations, I'm in Hong Kong and you are in the United States.
但是能够透过这样子的网络，我们还是能够在主的话上面彼此的勉励，一同的交通，这是主的恩典。
But through the internet, we can still fellowship and communicate with each other, and this is from the grace of God.
当然，我们也感谢主的保守，虽然在过去两堂开始有一点点的问题，还是主的怜悯，帮我们从一切的问题里面带过去了。
And of course, we thank the Lord's protection and guiding that for the past two sessions, we had a bit of technical difficulties, but we thank Him and these difficulties have passed already.
今天早晨是我们这三天的聚会来到最后的一堂。
And this morning, the session is going to be the last session that we have of the threes that we were having.
我们仰望主在这复活的早晨，把他更丰富的同在赏赐给我们。
And we look upon our Lord on this Easter morning that He will give us more abundant rewards.
我们在开始交通以前，我们先来看早晨我们要来读的这几处的经文。
Before we start sharing, we're going to look at the several scriptural verses that we will be sharing.
请大家听我念。第一处的经文在希伯来书第11章17到19节。
Please listen to me as I read. The first one will be from Hebrews chapter 11, verses 17 to 19.
亚伯拉罕因着信被试验的时候，就把以撒献上。这便是那欢喜领受应许的，将自己独生的儿子献上。论到这儿子，曾有话说，从以撒生的才要称为你的后裔。他以为神还能够叫人从死里复活，他也仿佛从死中得回他的儿子来。
By faith, Abraham, when he was tested, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was in the act of offering up his only son, of whom it was said, Through Isaac shall your offspring be named. He considered that God was able even to raise him from the dead, from which, figuratively speaking, he did receive him back.
我们第二次再看罗马书第九章。
Our second scripture reading will be from the book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 9.
第九节，因为所应许的话是这样说，到明年这时候我要来，撒拉必生一个儿子。
For this is what the promise said.About this time next year, I will return, and Sarah will have a son.
第三处经文，我们看加拉太书第四章第23节。
The third area will be from the book of Galatians, chapter 4, verse 23.
然而那使女所生的是按着血气生的，那自主这妇人所生的是凭着应许生的。
But the son of the slave was born according to the flesh, while the son of the free woman was born through promise.
哦，最后呢，我们再看创世纪第二十二章。
Finally, we're looking at the book of Genesis, chapter 22, verse 12.
天使说：“你不可在这童子身上下手，一点不可害他。现在我知道你是敬畏神的了。”因为你没有将你的儿子，就是你独生的儿子，留下不给我。
The angel of the Lord said, "Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, seeing you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me."
我们再点点祷告。
Let's have a bit word of prayer.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢你把我们带领。来到如今
Heavenly Father, we thank you for your leading until now.
当我们在这个复活的早晨，我们照着你话语的吩咐如此行，吃着饼喝着杯来纪念你儿子的时候，我们感谢你的同在。
And on this Easter morning, according to your command, we are eating of your bread and drinking of your cup, and to be with your Son.
但愿每一次我们在你的面前这样子的敬拜，这样子来等候的时候，主啊，你的应许，你的话早日的成就。
May each time of our worship and our praises will be according to your will.
我们感谢主带领我们这次的聚会，经过了两天两堂的时间，早晨来到这最后的一堂。
We thank our Lord for these past 2 days of the sessions, and now we finally arrive at our last session.
我们恭敬再把这段时间仰望在你自己的手中。
We respectfully place this time into your hands.
我们仰望你再把你自己的话说在我们心灵的深处。
And we look upon you, respectfully to speak your words into the depth of our hearts.
来开启我们的心，也就是圣灵引导我们进入这属灵的实际。
To review and open our hearts so that the Holy Spirit may lead us into the reality of our spirituality.
你听我的祷告，听我们众圣徒在你面前的呼吁。
Listen to our prayer and listen to all the worship of all our saints.
将荣耀颂赞归给你，奉主耶稣基督的名，阿门。
And may all glories and worship be given to you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
我们这一次特别着重在这个信心这件事情上面再一点的温习。
And this time we actually emphasize on the issue of the faith, and then we have a bit of review over that.
我们感谢主，借着希伯来书第三章的话，再一次来提醒我们。
And we thank the Lord through the words of the book of Hebrews in chapter 3, it's reminding us.
圣灵在那里给我们的话，乃是要叫我们透过了这些以色列百姓的历史来作为我们的警戒。
And the Holy Spirit hears through the words of His words to warn us through the experience of the Israelite people through the wilderness.
让我们能够懂得如何能够存着信心来走这条属天的道路。
So that we may know, understandhow to walk through this path of faith, through our faith in Him.
在神的心意里面，乃是要把我们领进他的那个安息的里头。
But the purpose of the Lord is to lead us into His rest.
正如同神的百姓，神把他们要引到这个的迦南的应许地里去。
And together with like His people, He is leading us into the land of promise.
这是一个非常重要的关键，乃是我们的信心。
And the very important concept is our faith.
所以圣灵在这里把这些神的百姓倒闭旷野这件事情来成为我们一个非常严肃的一个提醒。
Therefore, the Holy Spirit through the dying of the Israel people in the wilderness to become a very solemn and serious reminder for us.
并且很严肃地告诉我们说，我们进入了听见他的话，就不可以硬着心。
And very solemnly it's reminding us that now that we have heard his words, we must not harden our hearts.
像这些的百姓一样。
Just like these people.
我们是应当在神的面前来持定我们当初的信心。
And we should hold firm and move forward our confidence as in the beginning.
这样我们就能够在基督里面有份了。
In this way, then we will have a share in Christ. Then we can enjoy everything in Christ. We thank our Lord, His word, God's word, not only give us this reminder.
他也把许多信心的见证人摆在这书上来成为了我们的效法榜样和这个警惕。
And he wants to place all these so many witnesses of faith into the book, into the Bible, so that it becomes our warning and our reminder.
这一次我们特别再来温习我们信心的祖宗亚伯拉罕的一些故事。
And especially this time we're reviewing on the ancestors of faith, Abraham, his stories and his life.
虽然亚伯拉罕的故事我们都非常熟悉了。
This part of Abraham's story is actually we're all very familiar with it already.
但是对亚伯拉罕他一生的经历却常常来成为了我们在信心的道路上面一个非常重要的一个的榜样。
But for Abraham's experience in his life constantly,It's become a very important example for us.
因为神如何的引导他，如何在他身上来做工，也同样要在我们身上来引导，来做工在我们身上。
Because in the same way how God has led him and how he has worked in him will become the same way for us to lead us and to work in us.
我们读过亚伯拉罕的故事，从创世纪里头我们来看的时候，我们就晓得
When we read Abraham's story from the story in the book of Genesis, then we know.
如果要把他的生平来做一点的分段，也许我们可以把从十二章到二十这个五章分成三个段落。
And if we want to separate them into the divisions from chapter 12 to 25, we may separate them into three divisions.
我们看见十二章到十四章乃是他一个小段。
From chapters 12 to 14 is a small division.
然后从这个十五章一直来到这二十二章是另外一个的段落。
And then from chapters 15 to 22 will become another division.
从十三章一直到二十五章乃是到了晚年了，他末了的一段。
From chapter 23 to the end is talking about his old age is another division.
在这十二章到十四章的里头，我们看见他如何的梦到，如何的跟随主，神在他身上要叫他学什么的功课。
And from chapters 12 to 14, we see how he was called and how he followed the Lord and how he had grown in faith and how the Lord is.Leading him and teaching him.
我们看见在这段里面特别想到神来给他的应许，那是关乎到地的问题。
And here the promise that God gives him is about the land.
因为当他离开了加勒底乌尔来到迦南地的时候
，Because when he left the land of Ur of Chaldean and came to Canaan.
圣经给我们看见说。神在第十二章里面特别在那里说，那个地方乃是迦南人在那里的地方。
And God allows us to specially see in chapter 12 that Canaan is a land where the Canaanites were there.
他说那时迦南人住在那地。
And he says that at that time, the Canaanites lived in the land.
但是神却对亚伯拉罕说，他说，我要把这地赐给你的后裔。
But God actually said to Abraham, I want to give you this land to you and your offspring.
所以你就看见说，神把这个话给告诉亚伯拉罕，乃是让亚伯拉罕看见说，虽然在这个地方迦南人是不错，住在这个地方。
And this allows us to see that God is telling Abraham, yes, it's true, the Canaanites are living here in this place.
但是这个地方并不属于他们的，乃是我要给你的后裔的。
However, this place does not belong to them, but it's me, I want to give this to you and your offspring.
很稀奇，这个地当然是给亚伯拉罕，但是神却说，我要给你的后裔。
Amazingly, of course, this land is to be given to Abraham as well, but he said, I want to give this land to your offspring.
在这里乃是让我们看见说，神所给他的这个地，乃是永远祝福他的。
And so this allows us to see that, of course, this land will eternally be belonging to them.
虽然你看见迦南人在这里，但是这个地是给你的，一直到你的后裔也要在这个地的上面。
So although this Canaanite is there, but actually this land will, your offspring forever will be in this piece of land.
这个是神给他一个的应许，叫亚伯兰看见说，他来到这个地方，这个地方就是神所给他的。
Because this is a promise that this land is given to them from God, and this is a promise from them.
但是你知道亚伯拉罕虽然他相信神，但是他的信心也不过仅仅是一个开始而已。
Although you know that, we know that Abraham believed in God, but his faith, of course, is merely just a beginning.
他虽然对这位荣耀的神有点的认识，神也呼召了他。
Although he has knowledge and knowing God, and God has called him.
但是对于神要把这个地给他，他要来经历这件事情。
But towards the fact that God wants to give him this land and he has to experience this thing.
他来看见这个地并不是在地上的人的手里面，乃是在这位神的手里面。
When he looked at the land, he's seeing this land not in the hand of the Canaanite, the people who live there, but in God's hand.
所以神就在这生命当中来做一些的功夫。
Therefore, God then do some works in him.
因此当我们在读这段的时候，昨天我们就来看到这亚伯拉罕的一点点的故事。
So therefore yesterday when we were studying this part, we saw a bit of the story of Abraham.
神在这里乃是让亚伯拉罕看见说，他乃是至高的神，天地的主。
And here even allows us to see that he is the God most high, the possessor of heaven and earth.
是，虽然地好像是在这些人的手里面。
Yes, the land seems to be in the hands of these people.
然而从历史来看，亚伯兰也懂得说，这些地人能够拥有它，那是经过了人的那一个征战、人的努力、人的方法而来抢得来的。
And Abraham, of course, understand that these people who live there, they have gone through battles and wars and struggles and fighting in order to gain it.
这并不是亚伯兰他不懂的故事。
And this is not a story that Abraham did not understand.
但是神却说，这个地虽然现在迦南人在那里，我却要给你。
But God says, although this piece of land is now in the hands of the Canaanite, I want to give it to you.
然后神就一直一直这样子的来带领他，来认识这位神，那是管理全地的至高的神。
And then this,helps him and lead him in this way all the time so that he knows that God is the one who governs all things.
不仅只是在天上的神曾向他发出他的荣耀来的那一位。
Not only this God who is from heaven who reveals his glory.
他也是地上的主，主宰着一切的所有。
And he is also the Lord in this world that he governs and is in charge of all things.
所以当神把他带到迦南地，他在生命当中有软弱的时候，神容许他到了这个埃及的地方去。
And therefore, when God brings him to the land of Canaan, when he has weaknesses, God is still allowing him to go into there.
当然，假如要不然当初信心够强一点，他就应当再逐坛来求问神，他应不应当到加埃及地啊？
So of course, if his faith was stronger in the beginning, he should have built an altar and inquire of the Lord whether he should go down to Egypt.
但是借用雅各书第四章的话说，这个那里是形容这个以利亚，但是我放在亚伯兰身上来说，他也是和我们是同样性情的人呢、啊。
So in James chapter 4, although this is describing whether it's Elijah, but actually Abraham is also having the same kind of personality.
他也是看环境，看见在这个地方有饥荒，他不能再待下去了。
And he also see the environment that this land has famine and could not stay on.
所以他要为着他自己，为着他家里人，在那里想这个，想办法了。
So therefore, he has to try and do something for himself and his family.
所以从他理性来想，他唯一的看见就是那个埃及这一块地方是最他应当去的地方。
So therefore, rationally, he thinks that Egypt, this piece of land, is most ideal for him to go there now.
但是正因着他到埃及，事情就发生了。
But because he went to Egypt, things were happening.
当然亚伯拉罕他知道去埃及可以冒险的。
Because Abraham, of course, realized that going to Egypt is a kind of risk.
神所容许他发生的事，为了叫亚伯拉罕也认识一件事情，就是神在管理着每一件的事情。
God allows him to do all that and happens is God wants him to realize that God is in charge.
当他从埃及上来以后，我们都晓得了，他现在开始对神有进一步的认识了。
So when he came back then from Egypt, he now has another deeper knowledge of God.
他看见他从地里面所得来的丰富，并不是人的手，那是神的手。
He saw that the abundance he brought back from land is not through man's hand, but through God's hand.
也为着这个缘故，当罗德的仆人和他的仆人相争的时候
，And for this reason, when Lot's herdsman and his herdsman were struggling and are quarreling,
他能够大方的让罗德自己去选择
，And he can generously allow Lot to choose the land.
这是他生命里面能够往前进步的点
，And this is a point where his life is able to move forward.And improve.
再往前，我们才看见说他能够对所多玛王有那么样的表现。
And then when we move forward, we see how he can have such kind of behavior towards the king of Sodom.
摆在他面前的确是个非常大的诱惑。
Because what's placed in front of him is a great temptation.
有谁觉得说钱财更多一点没有这个需要？
And who can say that you have no more needs for money and wealth?
用世界话说，有谁嫌钱多了
？Using the words of the world is who would think money is too much for them.
但是亚伯拉能够说，我指着天地的主、至高的神耶和华起誓说。
But Abraham is able to say, "I raise my hand to the Lord God Most High."
你的一根线、一条鞋带，我都不要。
I will not accept nothing that belongs to him, not even the thread of the thong of a sandal.
免得你说你我亚伯拉罕是因着你而富足了。
So that you will never be able to say I made Abraham rich.
换句话说，亚伯拉罕清楚地知道说他能够有今天，他能够富足，乃是这位天地的主至高的神。
In other words, Abraham realized that he's able to be so rich and abundant today, the way he is because of this God Most High.
我的一切所有都是从神而来的，都是神的赏赐。
Everything that I have comes from God, they're all rewards from God.
因为这位神，他乃是至高的神，天地的主，管理着一切所有的。
Because this God is the God Most High,Process of heaven and earth governing all things.
那来到早晨，我们要来看的这些经文就往前，我们来看亚伯拉罕记述的故事。
And then, as we move forward this morning, we're going to continue to look at the story of Hebrews.
从十五章一直到二十二章，我们发现在这一段里面，特别神给亚伯拉罕的应许，乃是关乎儿子的事情。
And from chapters 15 to 22, we can especially see what here is talking about is a promise regarding the son.
当然儿子也是同样关乎到产业。
And of course, in the same way, is relating to inheritance.
所以当来到十五章的时候，我们就看见经过了他去与狮王争战，赢了这场仗，回来之后。
And of course, then in chapter 15, we see that after he has his battle with the four kings and after he returned,
神来向他显现。
And God reveals himself to him.
神来对亚伯拉罕说，他说亚伯拉罕，你不要惧怕。
And God said to Abraham, do not be afraid.
我是你的盾牌。
I'm your shield.
我必大大的赏赐你。
I will reward and bless you greatly.
神的讲这句话，当然对亚伯拉罕来说，那的的确确是个非常大的安慰的话。
Because what God says to Abraham now, of course, these are great words of comfort.
神说你不要惧怕。
Do not be afraid.
那很显然在亚伯那个时候心里面一定是很惧怕。
So obviously Abraham at that time must be afraid in his heart.
我们神当然晓得亚伯拉罕惧怕什么。
Of course our God realized what Abraham is afraid of.
虽然亚伯拉罕他能够打赢这一场的战争。
Although Abraham was able to defeat and win this battle.
他能够从这个狮王的手中把五王他们被掳去的东西抢回来。
He's able to fight with the four kings and take back everything that they have taken from the five kings.
但是当他安静下来，再想一想，哎呀，现在我是得罪了这个基大老马这一群的人了。
But when he comes down and reflect on it, he must be thinking, well, now I have offended King Chedorlaomer and his.Friend and his kings. What about if they turn around and come and deal with me? So, therefore, it may be that he has some fear in his heart.
反过来说，就是索多玛对他好像什么东西都愿意给他，也并不见得他对这个世界王就有安息的心啊。
And even this king of Sodom seemed to be giving him all the things, material things. It may not be that he has a heart of rest. Because I actually rejected him. I didn't accept what he had offered. But God knows Abraham. Therefore God said to him, do not be afraid. I am your shield.
我要大大的赏赐你。
I will give you very great reward.
哎呀，对于神这么样的一个安慰的话，亚伯拉罕当然要低头敬拜。
To such comforting words from God, of course, Abraham has to bow down and worship.
神来做我的盾牌，我还有什么可以恐惧的呢？
So if your God is my shield, what is there that I should be afraid of?
相信亚伯拉罕一定对神非常的感激。
So we believe that Abraham must be very grateful to God. Not only did God say, I'm your shield, that he said, I will greatly reward you. As if what he has rejected to the king of Sodom, don't be afraid, now I will give it to you.
但是没有想到神这么说一句话的时候，反而勾起了这个亚伯拉里面心思的故事来了。
Little did we anticipate that after God said these words to him, actually stirred up Abraham's emotions in him.
他的回应呢，就说：“我既无子，你还赏赐我什么呢？”
And he responds and he says, "Since I remain childless, what can you give me?"
我没有孩子，你就是更多给我，我也带不走的，有什么意义的呢？
I do not have any children. Even if you give me so much, I cannot bring it with me. So what is the meaning of it?
并且当我走了以后，成就承受我家里的产业的，就是这个生在我家里的这个大马色人以利以谢。
So after I'm gone, all this inheritance was given to this Eliezer of Damascus who grew up in my household.
虽然这个以利以谢他是仆人所生的，这个仆人可能被卖到这个亚伯拉罕的家来了。
Eliezer may be born of a servant and sold to Abraham's household.
但是他生了个孩子，叫以利以谢。
And but he gave birth to a child who's called Eliezer.
亚伯兰看作他大，亚伯兰没有儿子，就把他当作自己儿子一样的看待他。
Abraham watched him grow up because he had no children, so he treated him as his child.
所以亚伯兰想，我假如没有孩子，将来所有的都只能给这个人了。
So Abraham is saying, since I have no children, everything that I have now will be given to him.
因为神你既然都没有给我个孩子，生在我家里的这个就是我后嗣了。
God, since you have not given me a son, so the child who grew up in my household will then become my heir.
我们知道后嗣就是灵和产业发生关系的。
So now we know that then an heir is related to inheritance.
但是神说不，这个人必不成为你的后嗣。
But God says, no, this man will not be your heir.
你本身所生的才成为你的后嗣。
But a son coming from your own body will be your heir.
我本身所生的才是，我怎么能够相信得过来啊？
A child coming from my own body, but how can I give birth to a child now?
我结婚到今天来，到今天为止一个都没有啊。
So until today, I have not even one child.
现在你说要从我本身所生的才算我后嗣，但是你没有给我孩子。
But now you tell me that a son coming from my own body will be my heir, but I don't have any children.
圣经说，于是神就把他领到外面去。
But then the Bible says God then took him outside.
可能神在那里，在这个帐篷里面向他显现上的说话。
Because God there in the tents has revealed himself to him and spoke to him.
但是神把他领到外面去，叫他举目望天。
Then God let him outside and asked him to look up at the heavens.
到那个时候是晚上，你看看你天上的星，你能够数得过来吗
？And that the time is at night, and he said, "Look at the stars. Are you able to count them?"
有谁能够数得星星啊
？Who can count the number of the stars?
你一个一个在那数掉，数到什么时候，一下子又数乱掉了。
If you count them one by one, until when will you finish, and you get confused over counting them?
因为天上星星实在太多了。
Because the stars in heavens are too numerous.
但是神说，你的后裔就要像着天上的星这样的多。
But God said to him that your offspring, so shall your offspring be as in the stars in heaven.
很稀奇的，我们也感谢神。
And very amazingly, we thank God as well.
圣经说亚伯兰信耶和华。
And the Bible says Abraham believed in the Lord Jehovah.
神你这样说我就相信了，神就以他为义。
Because God, you say it, so I believe. And so God credited to him as righteous.
就因着亚伯拉罕这样子的信耶和华，耶和华就以此。以他的信称他为义。
And therefore, because of Abraham believing the Lord in such a way, the Lord Jehovah credited to him as righteous.
并且接下去，神还给他立约。
And to following, also God made a covenant with him.
哎呀，你也看到神来何等体贴亚伯拉罕。
And you can see how considerate is God of Abraham.
我们神是至高的神，他何需要跟人立约呢
？Our God is the God Most High. Why does He need to make a covenant with men?
他的话一说就是信实的。
And but God's words are real and faithful.
但是神竟然放下他自己来跟亚伯拉罕立约。
But God actually put Himself down to make a covenant with Abraham.
来进到亚伯拉罕的感受里面，接着这个约来叫亚伯拉罕 更清楚地知道说神所应许的神要成就。
Because in Abraham's feelings there, through this covenant, God promised him and showed him that what he said will be accomplished.
这实在是什么大的恩典。
And that is to say God will give him great grace.
但是话说回来，神说了这句话，并不是马上过了一年，哎呀，立刻就有了孩子啊。
But to come back and look at it, actually, God didn't, it doesn't mean that after he said these words, it will happen in a year or two and give him a child.
我们不知道神当时给他说话的亚伯拉罕已经到了几岁了。
We don't know when how old Abraham was when God spoke with him.
他75岁离开这个哈兰来到迦南地。
When he was age 75, he left Haran to go to the land of Canaan.
而来到十六章，在那里第三节告诉我们说，亚伯兰他已经在迦南地住了十年。
But then we in chapter 16 verse 3, it tells us that Abraham had already been living in Canaan 10 years.
所以前面神来向他说，你的后裔像天上那么星那么多，我相信也应当距离这个亚伯兰离开这个哈兰。来到那个时候大概已经三四年了吧。
So then, from the time when God said, look at the stars, numerous stars in heaven, until now, it should be about 3 to 4 years.
和且稍微多一点也不奇怪。
Maybe a little longer, it may not be too strange about that.
但是不管如何，从他结婚一直来到现在迦南，已经十年了，他还是没有孩子。
Regardless, it's from the time he got married until now in the land of Canaan, he still is 10 years already, he still had no children.
亚伯兰信不相信神呢？我相信亚伯兰对神是相信。
Does Abraham believe in the Lord? Of course, I believe that he did. He believed in God.
但是事实上是这的确是没有孩子啊。
But the fact remains that he still had no children.
因为你神说了以后呢 一年一年的过去。
But after God spoke to him about it, a year and a year, year after year, they passed.
那撒拉还是一样的，没有任何的动静。
Sarah is still the way she was without any signs of having child.
而且慢慢两个人年纪越来越大了。
And then slowly and gradually, they grow older, both of them.
所以现在尽管亚伯拉罕还是默默在那里等候啊。
So although now Abraham is still quietly there waiting.
撒拉她也有点忍耐不住了。
And Sarah herself was also getting a little bit impatient.
所以她肯定对亚伯拉罕说，神跟你说要给你儿子，但是一年一年过去，你看我也快不能生了，神还没有给我们儿子。
So Sarah said to Abraham, yeah, look, God promised you to give you a son, but year after year, look, we still do not have any children.
我不知道撒拉对这个亚伯拉罕他讲了多少次这样子的话。
I don't know how many times Sarah have spoken this way to Abraham.
但是不管这些话一定也成为了亚伯拉罕一个的压力。
And regardless of these words then become a pressure to Abraham.
终于有一天，撒拉来告诉他说：“我最爱的这个婢女夏甲，倒不如我把她给你做妾，然后你从她从你生孩子吧。”
And until one day Sarah came to him and this favorite maid of mine, a Hagar, I will give her to you to become a concubine so that she may bear children for me.
哎呀，亚伯兰听见了这个的建议。
And after Abraham heard the suggestion,
我想他心里面也是觉得说，哎呀，也的确是事实，我们都年纪大了。
Maybe he's thinking in himself, yes, this is a fact, we are all growing older.
而且这个撒拉讲话也是非常有智慧。
And Sarah is also speaking like with wisdom.
他对亚伯兰说是耶和华使我不能生孩子。
He said to Abraham that the Lord Jehovah caused me to be barren and not have children.
不是你的问题，还是我的问题呢？
It's not your problem, but it's mine.
神对你说是从你生的才是你的后裔。
Because God says is a child coming from your own body will be your heir.
神没有说从你生的是可以借用谁来跟你生啊。
God did not say that coming from your own body, but through which woman?
所以我把夏甲给你，也是从你所生的。
So if I give you Hagar, it's also coming from you.
我想亚伯兰听了觉得这倒是也是有点道理啊。
So I think Abraham, after he heard that, he may think that this makes sense.
所以就照着撒拉的建议，就把夏甲娶过来了。
So then according to Sarah's suggestion, then he took Hagar to be his concubine.
果然娶了这个夏甲过来第二年他就生了孩子了。
And in reality, actually, after he took over Hagar, yeah, the next year, she gave birth to a son.
因为圣经说等到这个从夏甲生出来的孩子以撒玛利出生的时候亚伯兰86岁。
Because the Bible said that when this son Ishmael was born of Hagar, Abraham was already age 85.
从75岁到了85岁。
From age 75 to 85.
他都还没有儿子，而且就住在迦南地。
And he still had no son, and he was living in the land of Canaan.
现在娶了夏甲，第二年就生了以撒玛利。
Now that he had Hagar, the next year.She gave birth to Ishmael.
但是
However,
孩子是生了。
Yes, the son is born.
神却不讲话。
God remained silent.
哎呀，弟兄姊妹，人都是聪明的。
And brothers and sisters, men are clever.
我们的肉体也有很多我们自己的想的办法。
Our flesh will come up with different kinds of methods ourselves.
我们常想我们可以帮神的忙。
And we constantly think that we can help God.
但是你没有想到你的帮忙是在说常常我们是帮到忙。
But little can you imagine that what you tried to do to help was actually doing it the other way.
我们看见以撒玛利是生下来了，但是从以撒玛利生下来，从86岁开始，一直到了亚伯兰99岁。
And we see that Ishmael was born and all the way until later and until Abraham was age 99.
就没有记载过神对亚伯兰说过任何的话。
The Bible did not record any words spoken by God to Abraham.
这四年里面神好像隐藏了。
And this thing seemed to be hidden.
神不再像从前一样常常向亚伯兰说话，向亚伯兰显现。
And it's like, unlike before when God constantly revealed himself to Abraham and spoke with him.
虽然好像亚伯兰的确是得了一个儿子。
And it seems, yes, Abraham seemed to have gained a son.
但是这并不是神所要给他的。
But this is not what God wants to give to him.
这是凭着人的肉体，凭着人的智慧，凭着人自己的办法而产生出来的。
And this is through man's flesh, man's wisdom, and man's method.A product of it.
所以神不讲话。
Therefore, that's why God was silent.
弟兄姊妹们，你我常常也同样有这样子一些的经历。
You and I constantly have such kind of similar experiences as well.
好像你的办法可以在某个程度上行通了一些事情。
As if your methods would be able to work it out for in some ways.
但是外面的亨通。外面的发达，你和神之间却远离得很。
Prosperity and advancement on the outside may put a hindrance before between you and God.
这是我们人的愚昧，常常被这些东西掩盖了我们的眼睛。
And these foolishness of ours constantly will cover our eyes.
就是孩子生下来，你也看见亚伯兰并不一点点就觉得说从此可以安息了。
Even after the son was born, you don't see that Abraham was gradually gaining any rest. Because now this Hagar, who had actually from a lowly position, now advanced into a higher position. Now she thinks that I'm having a child and...The mistress Sarah does not have any, so she's now despising her.
这件事情叫撒拉不满意，也叫亚伯拉罕非常的烦恼。
And this caused Sarah to be very unsatisfied, and Abraham was having a difficult time.
所以他只好对撒拉说：“她是你的婢女，你要怎么干就怎么干。”
And so she can only tell Sarah that she is your maid. Do whatever you want with her.
你看这人的肉体产生出来一点点，都并不是完全就可以解决问题。
So you see, when the flesh comes up with something, it's really not resolving any problems.
人同样看见有许许多多的难处和烦恼。
Men can still see so many difficulties and problems.
但是我们感谢神，神的呼召从来都没有后悔。
So, but we thank God, God's calling was never with regrets.
所以圣经说，等到亚伯拉罕99岁的时候，耶和华来向他显现。
The Bible says that the Lord Jehovah, when Abraham was age 99, the Lord Jehovah reveals himself to him again.
神对他说，我是全能的神，你要在我面前做完全的人。
So he said, I'm the Lord Almighty, in front of you, you must be perfect.
换句话说，神就给亚伯兰看见说，你一点都不完全。
So in other words, God was allowing Abraham to see that you are not perfect at all.
你要在我面前做完全人。
You must be a perfect person in front of me.
但是这个完全，谁能够叫你做完全人呢？
And because of this, why are you not a complete person?
神啊，就是我是全能的神。
God is saying that I'm the Almighty God.
我能够叫你达到完全。
I can cause you to become blameless.
我也要叫你在我面前成为完全人。
And I want to cause you to become a perfect person in front of me.
这是神再来向亚伯拉罕一显现对他说的话。
And these are the words that God spoke to Abraham as soon as he appeared to him.
然后神对亚伯拉罕重新再应许给他这个的后裔。
And God once again gave him this promise that the heir that he will be giving to him.
给他祝福，给他这块地。
Give him blessings and give him this piece of land.
神重新给他，告诉他说：“我要坚定我的约。”
And God once again to tell him that I will establish my covenant with him.
就他完全人，唯一的点就是你的肉体要被对付。
As a perfect and blameless person, your flesh will be dealt with bit by bit.
所以往下你就看见神要亚伯拉罕行隔离了。
So therefore you can see that God requires Abraham to carry out a circumcision.
神要叫亚伯拉罕行隔离，在他身上，在他肉体身上有一个隔离的记号。
God wants Abraham to have a circumcision so that in his flesh, in his body, will have a sign of circumcision.
当然我们知道说亚伯拉罕行隔离，从新约里面我们看见隔离的意义就是肉体的对付。
And of course from the New Testament we know, we realize that Abraham he's being circumcised. Circumcision represents dealing with the flesh.
因为哥罗西书第二章、腓立比书第三章都很清楚告诉我们说，这个隔离就是我们身上借着十字架对付掉我们的肉体。
And in Colossians chapter 2 and Philippians chapter 3 tells us that circumcision is dealing with, is a cross that is dealing with our flesh.
只有肉体被对付了，你才能够在神面前被带进更往前的一步。
It's only that when the flesh is dealt with, then you can be brought a step further.
你才能够往完全人这个步往前走。
So that...Can you then move towards the goal of being a complete and blameless person?
老神还继续对他说：“我要给你儿子，我必赐福给你。撒拉要生一个儿子。”
And God continues to tell him that I will give you a son, and Sarah will give birth to your son.
哎呀，不然现在来到这个地步，他好像不能信下去呀。
And Abraham, as if when he comes, arrives at this stage, as if.Is not able to go on believing.
他说：“你的妻子啊，不要再叫撒来，来叫撒拉，并且我必赐福给他，他也要从你的一个儿子。”
And he said, "Your wife will no longer be called Sarai, But he, she will be called Sarah, and also I will give you a son through her.
不然说，但愿以实玛利活在你面前就好了。
And but Abraham said to him, I as if may Ishmael be living in front of you.
但是神说不，不是这样子。你的妻子撒拉一定要给你生一个儿子，你要叫他给他起名叫以撒。
But God said, no, it, your wife Sarah will give birth to your son, and you need to call him Isaac.
然后神还告诉他说，明年这时节，撒拉必给你生以撒。
God actually told him next year this time, Sarah will have given birth to the son Isaac.
神就清楚告诉他说，撒拉一定给你生个儿子，叫儿子要叫做以撒。
And this verse is telling us definitely that Sarah will give birth to a son, and you could call him Isaac.
然后来到第十八章，我们更看见，当亚伯兰接待神的时候，圣经说，神对他说，明年这时候，我必回到你这里来，你的妻子撒拉必生一个儿子。
And in chapter 18, then the God actually appeared to Abraham again and told him, next year, this time, your wife Sarah will give birth to a son, and he will, she'll be called Isaac.
这是非常清楚地告诉亚伯拉罕说，你的妻子生的儿子，你要叫他叫做以撒。
And this is very clearly telling Abraham that your wife will give birth to a son, you are to call him Isaac.
当然故事再往前我们都知道了。
And of course, as the story moves forward, we all know.
到了死后，撒拉果然按着神所说的，她生了以撒。
At the right moment, of course, Sarah actually gave birth to a son, and he was called Isaac.
这以撒就照着耶和华按着先前所讲的话，撒拉蒙眷顾而生下来了。
So this was as God had promised before, and Sarah was giving grace, and then she gave birth to the son.
当这个以撒满月的时候，就发生了一个故事。
Then when the Isaac was a month old, there's a story again.
那就是以实玛利在那嬉笑这个以撒。
And there was Ishmael that was mocking Isaac.
所以叫这个撒拉非常的不高兴。
And it caused Sarah to be very unhappy about it.
他要叫这个儿子，他要叫这个以实玛利和他的妈妈要赶出去了。
And he wants to chase Hagar, the mother and the son, Ishmael out.
因为现在自己已经有了孩子了，而且这个孩子也是非常对我这个孩子不利啊。
And now that Sarah had her own son, and she feels that this older son was very harmful to her own son.
撒拉说：“这是你的儿子，不能够和我一直一同承受产业。”
And she is saying the son of this maid cannot inherit, together with my son.
亚伯拉罕就非常的忧愁，不知道怎么办。
And Abraham was very sad, didn't know what to do.
因为手板也是肉，手心也是肉。
Because both of them are, both of them are his sons.
但是神却对亚伯兰说，你不要为这个童子和你的婿女忧愁。
But God told him that do not worry about this young son.
神竟然对他说，凡是撒拉对你说的话，你都应当听。
And God is saying, whatever Sarah said to you, you must listen to.
因为从以撒生的才要称为你的后裔。
Because only the one who's, Anyone, the only one Isaac, the one who is born of you, will become your heir.
这是很清楚，神告诉他说，要从谁得着更多的后裔，那是以撒。
Because very clearly he's told him that who was he born of, that is Isaac.
你的后裔要像天上的星那么多，从哪里而来？以撒。
And your offspring was as numerous as the sky in heaven, and where do they come from Isaac?
要从以撒生的才能够叫你得着那个时候我要给你的这许多的后裔。
And only when those are born of Isaac will become the many, many offsprings that I talk about.
这一下子亚伯兰当然很清楚，也是非常的感动。
But here at this point, Abraham of course was greatly moved.
神啊，你现在既然是个儿子，而且神你一再这样说了，那我当然都接受了。
Because God, since you have already told me that, Of course, I will obey.
现在以撒玛利也出去了，所有的都一切都在以撒的身上。
So now that Ishmael is being chased out, everything will fall on Isaac.
这是他的独生子。
And this is his only son.
这是他心里面所爱。
And this is one who is loved by him in his heart.
但是没有想到这些事情过去了以后。
But little did he think about that after these things were passed.
来到第二十二章圣经说这些事以后。
And when here we come, it says after these things.
当然也包括了二十一章下面讲到亚比米勒的故事。
And here, of course, it included Abraham's the other story.
但神在这些事情过去后，神竟然来向亚伯拉罕讲另外一个话。
And after the story passed, God actually came to talk to Abraham about other words.
圣经说，耶和华神要试验亚伯拉罕。
Because the Bible says the Lord Jehovah wanted to test Abraham.
先试验亚伯拉罕，当然要把亚伯拉罕信心带到更高峰去。
God wants to test Abraham because he wants to bring his faith to another higher level.
的确来到这二十二章，我们看见整个亚伯拉罕生平里面最高峰就来到这二十二章。
So then when it comes to chapter 22,And we know the pinnacle of all this in Abraham's life is here.
也是亚伯拉罕信心最高峰的时候。
And this is the pinnacle of Abraham's faith.
因为神来对亚伯拉罕说，你把你的儿子，你的独生子，你所爱的以撒。
Because he told him, he said, take your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love.
你把他带到摩利亚地，在我所指定的山，把他献为燔祭。
And bring him to the land of Moriah and offer him there as a burnt offering.
哎呀，弟兄姊妹们，我们今天假如没有懂得亚伯拉罕故事，你要听这个话，你觉得说真的昏掉了。
Brothers and sisters, if we had not known the story of Abraham first, we might have just fainted.
我年纪大，我有没有听错呢？
Did I hear it correctly?
怎么可能会发生这个事情?
How is it possible that this is happening?
这岂不是神你亲口一再的说，从我生的才是我的儿子，撒拉要为我生的这个儿子。
Did God not repeatedly said that I will have a son and that will be given birth through Sarah?
你不是说从这个以撒生的才成为我的后裔吗？
Didn't you say that the offspring that comes from Isaac will then they be my offspring?
你叫我把他献上，献为燔祭给你，那通通都没有了，归回零了。
And now you ask me to offer him up and become a burnt offering, then everything will become zero, nothing anymore.
但是我们感谢赞美神，我们看见亚伯拉罕他对神的信的的确确是非常的信心。
But we thank and praise God, and that Abraham, truly his faith towards God is very strong. And we see that he did not hesitate. Early the next morning, he got up and brought his servant, and they went to Mount Moriah.
他到了这个山下，对仆人说，我带着童子到那边去敬拜一下。
And when he arrived at the mountain, he said that me and my child will go over there and worship.
然后他真的就把他儿子绑了，就放在坛上面。
And then he actually bound his son and put him on the altar.
他一点都没有迟延，也一点都没有困惑。
He did not hesitate at all, and was he puzzled?
他果然就把儿子放在坛上面，然后就要献为燔祭给神了。
And actually, he actually really placed his son and laid him on the altar to become a burnt.
当然，我们都知道这故事。当他举刀的时候，神叫他停手，不可下害这个童子。
But of course, we know the story. Just as he was raising his knife, the angel of the Lord called out to him and said, "Do not lay your hand on the boy."
神说：“现在我知道你是敬畏我的。”
God said, "For now, I know that you fear God."
他们说我。 亚伯兰的确是个有信心的亚伯兰。
Abraham is definitely a faith, person of faith.
圣经告诉我们，我们说罗马书说他相信神能够叫他死人从死里复活。
And the book of Romans told that God caused him to believe that God can cause the raise the dead.
亚伯兰对神的信。
Abraham's faith towards God.
但是我们来读这个希伯来书第十一章的时候，
when we read the book of Hebrews chapter 11,
我们看这希伯来书十一章怎么来形容亚伯兰这个的行动，
and we are reading how the book of Hebrews describing Abraham's actions.
我们刚才读过希伯来书第十一章告诉我们说，
and when we were reading the book of Hebrews chapter 11,
他说亚伯拉罕因着信被试验的时候就把以撒献上，这便是那欢喜领受应许的将自己独生的儿子献上。
Because by faith Abraham, when he offered up his only son Isaac, who had received the promise, was in the act of offering up his only son.
这里告诉我们说亚伯拉罕他献上他的儿子，不错，的确是信，这个是事实。
And here he tells us that Abraham offered up his son, that's through faith. That is a fact.
但是下面却有一句话说，这是那欢喜领受应许的，将自己独生的儿子献上。
But it follows to say that then he who had received the promises was in the act of offering up his only son.
我不知道我们平常读圣经的时候，有没有特别注意到这一个句话。
And so we don't know when we're reading the Bible in our days whether we have noticed this kind of phrase.
因为我们对亚伯兰献上他的儿子，他很显然的，我们觉得说这是亚伯兰对神的顺服。
And because when Abraham was offering up his son, we think that this is very obviously Abraham's submission to God.
这是亚伯兰相信神死无变为有，能够叫死人复活的。
And that is Abraham believed in the God who can raise the dead and he can turn something, nothing into something.
但是在这里就告诉我们说，亚伯兰的行动不仅仅是信心，不仅仅是顺服。
But here it tells us that Abraham's actions not just faith and not just submission.
乃是他欢欢喜喜领受了神的应许。
But that he was just very happily, cheerfully receiving the promises from God.
换句话，这句话乃是给了亚伯兰信心，亚伯兰顺服，来一个更具体的一个说明。
But in other words, this is a clear illustration of Abraham's faith and faith and submission.
换句话说，亚伯兰对神的相信，不仅仅相信神的作为。
In other words, Abraham's faith is not just in the actions and deeds of God.
亚伯兰说顺服神，他相信神能够做，那并不是仅仅这个神是全能的神。
Abraham submit to God because he believes that this is an omniscient and almighty God who can do anything.
亚伯兰说能够相信并且愿意这样子献上他的儿子，乃是因为他欢喜领受应许。
Abraham can believe and submit is because he believed that God can raise his son from the dead, and he received the promise. And he believed in the promise of God.
哎呀，弟兄姊妹们，我们当然我们都是很喜欢有神的应许。
Brothers and sisters, of course, we're all very happy to have promises from God.
我们都寻求神，也从神得了许多我们盼望得着的应许。
We seek God out and we hope to receive the promise from God.
当然我们感谢神，神的确是应许的神，在圣经里面满了他的应许。
But of course we know that God is a God of promise and the Bible is full of the promises of God.
但是对亚伯拉罕来说，什么是神给亚伯拉罕的应许呢？
But towards Abraham, what are the promises given by God?
当然我们读了这么多圣经，讲了那么久，我们都清楚神给亚伯拉罕这个应许，那就是以撒。
Because after we read so many parts in the Bible and what God has said, we now know that the promise from God, that is Isaac.
以撒乃是凭着应许而生的。
Isaac was given birth through a promise.
以撒的生出来固然是神的能力。
The birth of Isaac, of course, is the power of God.
固然是神的恩典。
Of course, it's the grace of God.
固然是亚伯拉经历神奇妙的作为。
And of course, it's Abraham's experiencing God's amazing deeds.
他也显然就是神给他的恩赐。
And it's obviously grace and gifts from God.
但是很感谢神，你看见亚伯拉罕他对神的认识。
But we thank God, Abraham's knowing and knowledge of God.
他乃是领受神的应许。
He was receiving the promise of God.
圣经一再的给我们看见。
The Bible repeatedly allows us to see.
刚才我们读加拉太书说，这个自主妇人所生的是凭应许所生的。
And just now, when we're reading the book of Galatians, that the slave, son of the slave, was born according to the flesh, son of the free woman was born through promise.
神要给亚伯兰生一个儿子啊，简单的很呐。
God, if God wants to allow Abraham to give birth to a son, that's a very simple thing.
是不是？神是说有就有，命立就立的神。
Right? Because God is the one who, if he spoke, it came to be. If he commanded, it stood firm.
我们看见在二十二章里头，亚伯拉罕到了这个亚比米勒那里去的时候。
And we see that in those chapters here, when it comes to the area with the king Abimelech.
亚比米勒结果因着也是要得了这个撒拉的缘故。
And Abimelech also in order to gain Sarah,
神降灾，神就叫他一家都不能生孩子。
And God sent down diseases and caused all his household to be barren.
这是在神眼中都没有难处。
And to God there is no difficulty.
但是偏偏你看见说神怎么一再对亚伯兰说的时候，神还要说明年这时候。
But then how is it that you can see God repeatedly said to Abraham, next year this time?
明年这时候我必定要再来的。
Next year this time I will come again.
我来，撒拉就要生一个儿子。
When I come, Sarah will give birth to a son.
所以你就很清楚地看见说，神讲这句话，神的应许包括了什么。
And you can then see very clearly when God said this, what does it include?
罗马书第九章，我们刚才读的圣经也清楚告诉我们说，神的应许，所应许的话是这样说。
And in Romans chapter 9 verse 9, it very clearly says that God's promise, and this is what the promise said.
到明年这时候我要来，撒拉必生一儿子。
This time next year I will return and Sarah shall have a son.
换句话说，神给亚伯拉应许，他把他自己摆在这个应许的里头。
In other words, God gave Sarah a promise, but he placed himself in this promise.
神自己在这个应许里面来成就他自己所应许的事。
God himself is in the promise to accomplish what he has promised.
他所认识的神，他所经历的。
The God that he knows, the God that he has experienced.
亚伯兰虽能够把以撒献上，因为他抓住的并不是神的能力，并不是神的作为。
That Abraham can believe is that because what he got hold of is not God's power, promise and ability.
他所抓住的乃是神的应许。
But what he holds on to is God's promise.
弟兄姊妹，这才是真的信心。
Brothers and sisters, this is true faith.
信心是建立在什么的地方呢？
What is the faith built on?
信心并不是建立在神里做的是什么东西。
The faith is not built on what God has done.
信心并不是观看神的作为。
Faith is also not just watching what God has done.
信心呢是建立在神里是应许的神。
And the faith is built on that God is a God of promise.
我抓住的就是你的应许。
What he got hold on to is the promise of God.
就是因着你应许，这以撒给我的。
And just according to your promise that you give Isaac to me.
既然这个应许是你的应许，我就完全能够相信。
And, because this promise is your promise from you, so I can totally believe and trust.
现在你叫我把以撒献上，我能够相信。
And now that you ask me to offer up Isaac, I can believe.
因为现在不是你能不能的问题。
And because now is not a question of whether you can or you cannot.
当然你绝对能，你能够把以撒拿去，你也能够把以撒再给我。
Because if you can take Isaac, you can give Isaac, take Isaac away, you can give Isaac back to me.
当然你是全能的神，你可以使无变为有。
Because you are an almighty God and you can turn nothing into something.
但是现在不是你能不能的问题。
So now is not a question of whether you can or you cannot.
那是你说你应许的。
Because it's when you say you promise.
就是应着你的应许，所以我敢把这个摆在坛上。
Because of your promise, now I dare to place this on the altar.
弟兄姊妹们，这就是真的信心。
Brothers and sisters, this is true faith.
信心并不是建立在神的工作上。
And the faith is not built on God's work.
并不是建立在我们看见神的作为上面。
Is not through our watching God's deeds.
信心的是神对你说的话，他应许了，你相信。
God is through God's words. He promised and you believe.
因为他应许了，所以神在做什么，对亚伯兰一点都没有难处。
Because he has promised, so therefore towards Abraham, there's no difficulty at all.
所以你说把你的儿子，独生的儿子，你所爱的以撒献给我，我就愿意献上。
So because if you say that offer up your son, the Isaac that you love to me, then I believe and I do it.
这正是神在亚伯兰身上一直做工作到地步，把亚伯兰带到最高峰的时候。
And this is how God has been working through Abraham all the time until he lead Abraham to this high point and pinnacle of his faith.
他告诉他说要给他后裔。
Because he told him that he will give him an offspring, an heir.
他往前说要从你而生的才是你的后裔。
Because it will, this will have to come, this heir will have to come from your own body.
他说撒拉必定给你还生个孩子。
And he said, Sarah will give birth to a son for you.
但是神却说明年这时候。
But God says, this time next year,
我要来。
I will return.
撒拉要生一个孩子。
And Sarah shall have a son.
哎呀，弟兄姊妹们。
Brothers and sisters,
神要给亚伯拉罕以撒，犯不着神自己来啊。
God wants to give Abraham Isaac. He didn't have to do it himself.
随时都可以叫撒拉生孩子。
He can call Sarah to give birth to children anytime.
但是神却对亚伯拉罕说，明年这时候我要来。
But God said to Abraham, next time this year, I will return.
这就给我们看见神把他的应许，把他自己放在他的应许的上面去了。
And then this causes us to see that God placed himself in that promise.
神要对他自己的应许完全负责任的。
God wants to be totally responsible for his own promise.
这才叫我们信心能够完全绑在神的身上。
Then this will totally bound our faith into God.
我们所相信的就是这样子一位神。
The God that we believe him is this such a God.
我们信的是神的应许。
What we believe in is God's promise.
所以从这里你回头来到第一天，我们看见这个希伯来书第三章的故事。
So therefore this causes us to return to the story in the Hebrews chapter 3.
你看见这些以色列百姓，他们眼睛所看的就是神的工作，神的作为。
And you see that the Israelite people, what their eyes were looking at was God's work and God's deeds.
神对他们应许是把他们带到迦南地，这个的应许他们都忘记了。
God's promise to them is to bring them into the land of Canaan, and this promise they have taken.
他们一切都只看眼前。
They were just looking at things that's in front of them.
他们一切都看自己的好处。
They were just looking at what benefits they were having.
他们只盼望就神，你做很多的事情。
And they have been saying, God, you do this and you do that, so many things they want.
他们的信心就建立在这些的事情上面。
And their faith was just built on these kind of things.
弟兄姊妹，如果我们的信心建立神做些什么？
Brothers and sisters, our faith is just relying on what God is doing.
我们的信心建立是神在这个世界有些什么工作，显出的是神的作为。
If our faith is just built on God's doing in this world and to reveal His deeds,
我们的信心很容易就失落了。
Our faith will be very easily lost.
神不就是做事的神。
God is, yes, it's true. God is a God who does work, who works.
神一直到今天都在做事。
Until today, He's still working.
他为着他那永远的旨意，他在那做他的工作。
For His eternal will, He's always doing His work.
但是神做事不一定照着你的方法，不一定照着我的想法。
God, but however, God does not just work according to your thinking and my methods.
当我们眼睛只看着神到底你有没有做这事情的时候，我们的信心就会软弱了。
Because if we are just watching whether God is doing this thing, our faith will become weak.
我们就会摇动。
We will then sway and move and shake.
但是如果我们的信心建立在神的应许的上面。
However, if our faith is built on God's promise,
那我们就能够稳固了。
Then we can remain strong and firm.
因为亚伯拉罕所信的这位神不仅仅是应许的神，他把自己放在他的应许上面。
Because the God that Abraham believes in, not just a God of promise, he placed himself into that promise.
我们感谢赞美神，我们的主实在是应许的主。
We thank and praise God, our Lord is truly a Lord of promise.
他一面给我们圣经里面许许多多他的应许。
On one hand, give us so many promises in the Bible.
这个还并不是太重要。
And this is still not the most important.
神的应许那是有一天他要再来。
God's promise that one day he will return.
他的应许那是告诉我们说有一天这天地都要废去。
And his promise is telling us that heaven and earth will one day pass away.
他允许有一天我们每一周这样子不平，我们要与他一同合身的。
That he said that he's promised that one day we will be together with him.
他的应许告诉我们，我们将来那个荣耀的盼望就是建立在他的应许上面。
And he tells us that one day the hope that we have is built on his promise.
这是我们从进门一直到主再来，我们应当持守在神这个应许的上面。
And this is from our entrance until our Lord's return. Our promises, our hope is to be relying on His promise.
我们的信心就建立在神自己的话语上面。
And our faith is built on God's own words.
一直叫我们能够不只受世界一切的环境的摇动而影响了我们那个信靠他的心。
And that it will not cause us to be swayed or moved by the world.And our faith is continued to be built in Him.
求主恩待怜悯我们。
May God be gracious and have mercy on us.
让我们从这些温习的功课上，我们再次彼此的勉励，彼此的提醒。
And so that from these lessons that we're reviewing, that let us encourage and exhort each other.
让我们眼睛只定睛在神的身上。
So that our eyes will only fix our gaze on our God.
只抓住神自己的应许。
Just hold on to God's own promise.
持守这个信心直到主的再来。
We'll hold firmly to this faith till the return of our Lord.
求主向我们施恩怜悯我们。
May our Lord be gracious and have mercy on us.
将他的话给我们都有回头的亮光。
And that his words will give us light.
我们低头祷告。
Let's bow our head in prayer.
主我们感谢赞美你。
Lord, we thank you and we praise you.
赐给我们这三天彼此能够交通的机会。
Give us this opportunity of sharing with each other these 3 days.
但愿你的话给我们有回头的亮光。
That your words may cause us to look upon you.
但愿圣灵引导我们进入你自己的话语的实际里头。
May the Holy Spirit lead us into the reality of your own words.
当世界一切都困扰我们的心的时候
When the world has so many problems that is causing us to be confused
主啊愿你应许的话和你这位应许的神来坚固我们的心
May your own words of promise and you a God of promise to strengthen and firm up our heart
让我们能够望断以基于耶稣
So that we will just look at this Lord Jesus Christ,
来等候你自己的再来
to wait upon your own return.
将荣耀颂赞归给你。
May all glories and praises be given to you.
你祝福我们，也祝福给你的教会。
Please bless us and bless your own church.
听我们的祷告，奉靠主耶稣基督的名。
Listen to our prayer in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray. Amen.
好，感谢主。